Alright, welcome back to another video. We are back. This time we are recording and driving. It's been fucking ages since I've made a YouTube video. We're back, boys. I am en route to the gym now, as we speak. I'd say it's fair weird for other people driving past me seeing like a big camera stuck up. I got this idea off Connor Mannon? I think that's how you say his name. He'll know I'm on about him. Because I saw him set up this tripod in his car and I was like, that looks risky, but I'm fucking here for it. So, yeah, if this camera falls, I'll be very fucking depressed. Because she sent me back about 750 quid. Is she gonna fall, lads? I hope not. But yeah, today I'm in fear. Right, I nearly just crashed, so I'm gonna sack the camera and I'm gonna catch you when I'm outside the gym. Bosh. Oh my fucking god. I am lucky to not be in a crash. Right, so, thank god I didn't have the camera up, right? Because I had to hit so hard in the brakes, the camera went through the fucking window, right? So, I'm driving, right? I'm chilling, alright? Polo G's playing, Chosen One, absolute tune, alright? I'm driving, I'm chilling, I'm just driving, like, alright? I'm coming up, right, to a traffic light, okay? Left lane is for people going straight and left, yeah? Right lane is for people going right, okay? So I indicate to go into the right lane, okay? I drive into the right lane, all right? I see this one, right? She's at a garage, all right? I see her, she's like, you know when someone's trying to pull out and you're like, you're not gonna do that, are you? You won't do that, will you? Right, okay? So I'm looking at her, right? She sees me coming, all right? There's no way she doesn't see me coming, all right? Now, bear in mind, I'm in the middle of the road because I'm going into the right lane. It verges into a right lane, right? So, and I'm indicating, all right? So what does she do? She fucking swings out. I'm like, what are you doing, all right? So she's completely pulled out in front of me. Doesn't even look. Like, she doesn't stop either. She just goes, all right? I was in fourth gear. Swing her into second, I'm skidding, like, I literally felt the car skid, and, like, I didn't even have time to beep the horn, because I was like, what is happening, please don't let me die, like, I couldn't even, like, process what was happening, I was like, please don't hit me, I literally, like, man, that would have been so bad, like, I'm pretty sure her daughter was in the passenger seat, I would have literally hit her daughter, man, what is she doing, and then, yeah, the cheek of this one, right, I drive past her, she's like, give me a bad look, like, woman, like, learn how to drive. Do you know what I mean? Don't be swinging out in front of me, man. Idiot, man. Idiot. And she nearly hit your man in the left lane as well. Because obviously I was in the right lane. He was in the left. We both had to fucking slam on the brakes. What are you doing, Bjorn? Come on, man. Go do your test again. Holy shit. Oh, my God. That's angered me so much. And I wish I beeped. But I'm also like, oh, I'm lucky to be. Like, I'm lucky I didn't hit her. Do you know what I mean? But yeah. Anyways, apologies. We're in for push. Going doing bench press today. Fuck me, I just want to start training at this stage. My head's rattled. Bloody lucky to be here. Anyways, right, let's go in. Let's go train push. We're in for Munster Pro. Best gym on the Limerick Clare border. Unbelievable. Would recommend to anyone who's in UL. You kind of need to be driving. Or if you're living close to the pavilion, like if you're living kind of Capa Villa or anywhere around that area, why is this lighting terrible? I'd recommend going there because you can like walk from the pavilion. It's like 10, 15 minute walk. Phenomenal gym. Really, really good. Really, really quiet. So yeah, less talking. Let's go fucking train. All right, let's go.
All right, boys, we are back. So, since I hadn't recorded a YouTube video in months, you know me, I forgot to plug in the mic. So, yeah, nice one, Sam. Well done. So, I actually plugged it in on my third set of incline press. So, you've got a few more sets of me chatting shite as a voiceover, right? So, just stick with me, lads. Stick with me. But first time back on bench in ages. I'd say it's been a year. So, I just said to Dave, I was like, look, I quite enjoy doing this. I kind of go through phases with the bench. I'm like, yeah, I really enjoy it, and then I just like don't get stronger and I just take it out of the program again. So give it about 4 to 6 weeks, it'll probably be gone. But top set here, last week I got 80 for 7, and this week I wanted 80 for 8. Now you'll see, I think that's maybe rep 6. This is rep 7, and then here's rep 8. I got very, very close. That's rep 7 there. And then this is rep 8. Yeah, so as you can see, very close. But I'm not going to count it, seeing as I did get a spot. Then for the back offset then last week, I got 70 for 9, I think. 11. So I just wanted 11 or more. Sorry, I wanted more than 11, not 11 or more, to progress, because I didn't progress my top set, so I was quite annoyed. I'm pretty sure I got 12 or 13. I have it logged on my phone. But progressed here, which is very, very nice. That is the thing about bench. I feel like it's just different to a lot of other exercises. Like, it can just be so difficult to progress. So yeah, but I'm buzzing to be back on it. It's nice to have a bit of like bro back in the split, you know what I mean? So a bit of a grinder for that last rep there. And was quite nervous as well because I did not have a spot, but you know, ended up okay. Here's me talking like a dickhead thinking my mics were plugged in. But what I was talking about here was the like logging the level of seat that you have on. So like if I bring the seat down lower, like I'm literally doing a different press. So make sure when you do put in your logbook that you log the seat number that you have the machine set up on. So incline press here, this is a Life Fitness press. This is fucking lovely, lads. Like, it's actually amazing. Like, you can see there, it converges in. Oh, I absolutely love it. So last week I got 70 for 7 and I just wanted to beat that. I know I bet it, but I can't remember how many reps, to be honest. I think I could have got 8 or 9. But yeah, like, I'm glad to be back behind the camera. Like, I do really enjoy these YouTube videos, but I was just like quite stressed with college for the past few weeks, and I still am, and I have exams coming up, but I just didn't really know how to balance it. But now I kind of have a better idea of how to balance it. So yeah, I'm gonna try bring back some videos. Because, you know, I mean, I had one or two people asking me, and that kind of meant a lot to me, because like YouTube videos take a lot more sacrifice than like a TikTok video. So to know that people were like wanting me to go back recording was like a really cool feeling. So I appreciate anyone who texted me, you know, it does mean a lot to me. So yeah, here's my back off set. So on this exercise, I have three sets. And so I do a top set and then two back off sets. I'll usually do like a heavier back off set and a lighter back off set. So I think here I went for 65. And I definitely progressed, and then I went 55 then for a second back off set and got like closer to 15 reps. So here I think I could have got like 11 or 12. And then for the second back off set, then I think I got closer to kind of 15 reps. But yeah, my mic's plugged back in. So this is the end of the voiceover. So yeah, enjoy the rest of the video.
Right. Turns out my mics have been turned off. For how long? I don't know, but we're back, all right? So, I don't think I explained the last ones because my mics were off. Well, I did explain, but you won't be able to hear me. So I did 75 for one set, 65 for another, and I'm going to do 55 now. So progress the last two sets by a rep on each set, so couldn't be happier with that. So I'm going to do a third set now. So yeah, another little thing I ran through at the start, which obviously got cut out as well, was your seat position. So make sure when you do like log your weights in your phone, make sure you're logging the position you have the seat on as well. Because like, I could come in one week and do it down here, and it's a completely different movement pattern. Like, I'm pressing from here, whereas if I come up and put it on, say, like number 4, which I always do it on, I'm pressing from here. It's a completely different like movement. So make sure you do log the setting you have your seat on. So third back or second back off set now. So my third set. So 12 reps to beat on 55 kg. So let's beat it. Okay, so plus a rep there. Also very happy with my form on that set. Like, I feel like I'm really getting depth and having good technique. So next exercise is a pec deck. I was actually running the one here. I don't know if you can see it in the lens now, but it's an Apollo pec deck and it's actually really nice. But after mixing about and I was training with Dave Baker, we were talking about the other pec deck. There's another one over there. It's a Life Fitness one. And it's so nice, you can converge so well. So I'm actually gonna switch to that one. So I'm gonna go over now. It's gonna be my first time running numbers. I didn't actually track numbers that time I trained it with Dave. So just gonna track numbers this time. So yeah, I'm gonna do probably 2 or 3 sets there. And then shoulders and then arms, or shoulders and then triceps.
So the thing I love about this pec deck is it's so easy to drive your biceps in together. So when we're doing the pec deck, like what you want to think about is bringing that bicep across the chest. Like you want to join those elbows together in the squeeze. Keep these shoulders rolled back, like don't be leaning forward like this. Keep these shoulders rolled back. Don't be doing it like this. Like focus on bicep across the chest. Because literally that is the function of the pec, to bring your bicep across. Right, gonna go for a top set here. So let's see what we can do. Okay, 9 good reps, so happy with that. So like I said, first time on this machine, so just gonna log that 45 for 9. So thing about this one is as well, it's so heavy in the short, so it's so heavy in the squeeze, so it's really good. Right, second set on this. So obviously goal is kind of 10 plus reps. Reps there, very happy. Gonna do some for the lateral now, tricep extension, overhead extension, chalk it. Right, so I'm gonna go for a cuff lateral. So hop in here and get it done. That's too light. So that was 20 for 11, I think. So gonna go with that weight again, and then try, obviously, like get close to 11 again.
so. All right.
I got way too bored of being optimal, so we're doing that also. But I'm going to be an idiot and do a set with the 15th, and then I'll do a set with the 12th. Okay, so that is a wrap on laterals. So I did one set of the cable ones and then got bored and did laterals. Probably not optimal. Now, speaking of being optimal, I'm gonna do some straight bar pushdowns. Oh, but Sam, you don't bias the thoracic, iliac, short, lengthened of the tricep. Like, I don't give a fuck, okay? I'm gonna do these and then maybe a rope pushdown or something. I really enjoy these, especially when I have this attachment. It's quite nice, and oh my god, I can't get full range of motion. Who cares? Who actually cares? To be honest, the past, kind of 3-4 months, I've sacked just trying to be, so optimal, and, I've just picked movements that I connect well with, and I've noticed more growth than I ever have before. And more enjoyment, man. I come into the gym, I'm like, oh, a bit of bench today, boys, you know what I mean? And, it's just way more crack, man. And the whole reason that, I kind of bring it back to the whole reason I started this journey was because I love it. I love doing this shit. And the last thing I want to do is just pick exercise. Oh, okay, yeah, I might notice an extra 2 pounds of muscle. Obviously, not that much, but, an extra bit of muscle from doing this exercise. I don't really care, man. Do you know what I mean? This is more, this whole journey, this whole process is more to me than just making progress. This is just an enjoyment process. That's the reason why I started. I started documenting this because I really enjoyed it. And I found myself not enjoying my exercise, not enjoying my training. And then when I tried to record and talk through my exercises and my training, I just wouldn't even enjoy it because I was just I'm not even enjoying my session. How am I supposed to enjoy making YouTube videos when I don't even enjoy training? Do you know what I mean? So I just came to the conclusion, I was like, do you know what? Maybe I might sacrifice a bit of muscle, but I'm gonna bring up the enjoyment by a lot more. So sort of kind of started doing. So yeah, I'm gonna do a set of triceps now. We'll see you again. Also, if you find yourself that you are in kind of a rut like that, or in you're just at that stage where you're you've just noticed that you've changed your training style so much and you just don't really enjoy it. At the end of the day, you're probably gonna grow more by doing number one exercise you connect well with, because you know what muscle group you're training, you know how to target that muscle. I connect so well with barbell rows, so I just do barbell rows. And I've noticed more growth in my back, but number one, you're gonna probably grow more because first of all, you'll be able to connect with the movement. And second of all, you're gonna enjoy doing it, you know what I mean? So you're probably gonna push yourself harder. I way prefer it. I connect so much better than doing getting a big bar, putting D handles on it and getting more range motion. Fuck that, I'm just not on that buzz anymore. So yeah, if you find yourself you're in that rut, maybe just reassess and say to yourself, well, maybe I actually might be more optimal by being suboptimal. You know what I mean? By putting your happiness and enjoyment ahead of, being optimal, So yeah, that's just a quick one. Bosh, all right, that's two sets done. So we're going to do another here and then two of a rope extension and we'll chalk it then.
Also, boys, anyone who likes a bit of drill when they're training, fucking tune it.
Proper scouse tune this. But going to do a rope extension now. So did three sets there, so we're going to do, what, three sets of rope extensions as well.
That's three sets.
Oh my god, I feel like my tricep is gonna fall off, but that's three sets on all those done. And so that's a wrap on the push session, and so I'm gonna leave this video here. And I might do like a day in the life, maybe. I'll kind of see, I'm not really sure where I wanna go with this whole YouTube thing. But I said, bored today, I said I'd come in and do a little video. So yeah, please drop a comment, let me know what you think. Any questions, let me know. How else do you finish off these videos? Oh yeah, subscribe, maybe like, all right? Sound lads.